Attorney General Jeff Sessions oversaw the release of the DOJ terrorism report, and he joins us tonight. Mr. Attorney General, thanks for coming on.
Good to be with you.
So given these numbers, it does give new urgency, I think, to the immigration negotiations going on right now in Washington. You were involved in a number of efforts, I think in 06, 07, 13, to scuttle attempts at amnesty. And during that time, I remember you saying the Washington establishment supports any kind of border enforcement as long as it doesn't work. What did you mean by that?
That's exactly correct. Anytime a proposal like a wall or to fix this idea that you can claim you're afraid to go home and you get to stay in the United States, or you have problems where we provide subsidies to people who come illegally, the more you subsidize it, the more you get of something. These kind of failed policies are just never going to work, and the American people don't believe in it, and we've been trying to reform it, and every time you come up with a reform that works, gets blocked. And so President Trump has said, we have immigration, we want immigration, but we want to vet these people. We want to know who they are and make sure they're going to be productive people, people who will flourish in America, who are going to not be terrorists, not be criminals, and that's exactly correct for America. It's just unbelievable to me that we have the resistance we're having today to the reforms that are on the verge. We are close to having reforms that will actually work today.
And that voters voted for, by the way, in 2016.
A big issue in this election. Trump took it directly to the American people. It was a huge factor in his victory. Yet the same crowd that fought for the amnesty before is still trying to scuttle good reforms today.
So apparently, here are features of the proposal we're now looking at. It would fund just about 10% of the proposed border wall, about 70 miles out of 2,000. No enforcement, basically. You can't deport anybody. It would expand at chain migration. Dreamers could bring their relatives. It makes a diversity lottery more low-skilled. It doesn't seem like it's moving in the right direction.
Totally unjustifiable. That cannot be. That is not a proposal that has any prospect of success. They need to look at the proposal that House Judiciary Committee, Congressman Goodlatte, has proposed. That will work. It will end the illegality, make a tremendous progress toward ending illegality, and make the system work better. That's what the American people want. And the objectors, the sanctuary cities, the New Jersey policy you just talked about, those are policies that favor illegality. They subsidize illegality. They encourage illegality. American people are sick of that. It's time to end it. The choice is clear, and it's going to be even clearer this year. We're going to have some votes in Congress. People need to be held to account. Are you going to fix this system, create a system that protects America? We know that, as you said, 73% of the people who've been arrested for terrorism came here, were born abroad. So if they had been properly screened and rejected, we wouldn't have had these attacks in our country.
So someone I spoke to with direct knowledge said that in his meeting with the president on immigration, Lindsey Graham summed up his closing argument by reciting Emma Lazarus's poem from the Statue of Liberty. Not really a case that you'd expect Republicans to be making. Why aren't there more articulate Republican members of the Congress making the case that you just made?
Well, I wish there were, actually. I think people need to get focused on this. We are not against immigration. The president is not against immigration. What the American people want, have a right to, and what's good for America is a lawful system of immigration. And when we admit people to our country, we should be like Canada. We should evaluate them and make sure they're going to be lawful, they're not threats to us, they have the education and skills leveled to prosper in America. That's good for them and good for America. What good does it do to bring in somebody who's illiterate in their own country, has no skills, and is going to struggle in our country and not be successful? That is not what a good nation should do, and we need to get away from it. A good debate needs to be happening this year. The president is right on the lottery. That's ridiculous. How absurd is that for a policy for a great nation? We need to tighten up on our admission of people from dangerous areas of the globe where we can't vet, where we have high numbers of terrorists that live in those areas. We should certainly be more careful and limit that kind of immigration.